Now I will show you how to make this sales summary. Like this one, today sales is 160, yesterday 650, last 7 days 2632, last 30 days, and so on. I will show you also the data, which is the same data from Excel. So if we can see here today sales, so this is the one today, because this one is 2019, and this one is today, so 160. Yesterday 650 is the one, 7 days, 1 2 3 4 5 6 7, so 2632, this is the one. And this year, excluding this one because 2019, lock 2792. Year, current month, total sales, this one, including 2019. Okay, now I will show you how to make this one. Of course, we need a query. Okay, let's start. First, we need to create a new database, sales summary. Now I will extract the table, import from here. Now we have sold items. This is the total 2952, and here also 2952, all this including this 2019. Okay, now we will build a query. First, we create a query. Double click the one. Just select this one. Press Shift key, then and drag it down. So we will rename this one today sales. We will put criteria more than or equal date, okay, today August 15, we have 160, so this is correct. Okay, we'll save. We will just only copy, paste. Now I will rename yesterday. Then we'll modify our criteria. Here, between date and date, current date minus 1. So this is summary of yesterday sales, lock 650, and here I will highlight this one. This one yesterday. o'clock the same yesterday. 6:50. Next, we'll copy again. Paste 7 days sales. Yesterday, we'll copy this one. This one minus 1, so this is 7 days. Look, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So you see the total here. Maybe manual total sum 2,632. So here, 7 days, 2,632. So it's the same data here. So our formula is correct. And now I will copy again. Then current month. Now we will modify, of course we need to delete this one, and we need to cut this one, month, then month, then bracket. Then our transaction date, close bracket, close parenthesis. So this is our month, and here we'll put our criteria, month, then our function date, and close parenthesis. Here, look, if we will view this one, it includes here. I will look, if I view this one, as you can see here, although the month is 8, but excluding or including 2019, so our data for current month is wrong. So we need to put another expression here. We'll copy this one. Say format, then open bracket. Transaction date, then close bracket, comma, and now the format is year 1, 2, 3, 4, double quote, then close parenthesis, and here we need to put year. Here we need to put year and current date. Look, we will see here unidentified format. This is format. Look. Now, excluding 2019 for the current year with the current month. So our data for current month is 2,792. Correct. Now, the current year. Of course, I just only copy this one. Current year. Self-explanatory, we will just only delete this one. And this is the current year. We will see, look, current year, which is 2792. Here, current year 2792. Correct. And here, the total sales. We just only copy this one. Total sales. Of course, just only remove this one. And this is the total sales, which is the same data here. So this is how to calculate our sales summary with our query. For the next video, I will show you how to make the dashboard using this query result, this one. We will make that one for the next video. Thank you and God bless.